Hello and welcome to All About the Disco. I am your host, as always, Billy, for a rare, very rare recap episode of from this past Sunday's event for Discovery Wrestling at Portobello Town Hall. This was an incredible night. My first ever Discovery Wrestling show. My cherry has been popped well and truly, and I was treated to a very nice night of afternoon of professional wrestling in Edinburgh, in the capital. Again, ignore quality of the camera that is still ongoing. I'm still looking for a new camera, so I will hopefully next time we do an episode of All About the Disco, I'll be a nice HD or ish HD-ish quality, or I might gain my ears back. That might happen. I don't know. We'll find out soon. But yes, so we're going to recap the show, tell you what happened, ish, give a bit of a Cliff Notes version, and I hopefully will not forget anything. So, and give you all the announcements that happened on this particular show as well. So there's a lot to get into, so let's just get into it. So we kicked off the Joe Hendry era of Discovery Wrestling, good and proper, with intent, when we had Leon Slater take on Joe Hendry in Discovery Wrestling Y Division, easy for me to say, Discovery Wrestling Y Division Championship, number one contendership bout. The winner would receive a Y Division Championship opportunity in the near future. This was incredible. Leon Slater making his Discovery Wrestling debut, and all those things you hear and all those things you see on Impact, also on TNA Impact, and all the clips you see online, the matches you see online from Leon Slater, does not do that man justice. He is a phenomenal talent, ridiculously athletic. And when he goes in with someone of the caliber of Joe Hendry, it just made it a wonderful contest. Back and forth, lots of almost near falls from both. We also got to see Leon Slater just show his athleticism. It was just, I can't praise this match enough. I mean, this is a fantastic show all round, but the opening bout sets the tone for the evening. When an opening match is this good, it really sets the tone for a wonderful night of wrestling. But eventually, Leon Slater was able to pick up the win with his Swanton 450. Beautiful maneuver to put away Joe Hendry for the 1-2-3. An absolutely incredible contest. Like, I've praised this match for the last couple of minutes because it was just phenomenal. But it was just a tantalizing, beautiful match to kick off Discovery Wrestling in Portobello Town Hall. After the match, we had Joe Hendry congratulate his opponent, Leon. And Leon wanted his title shot that night. He wanted to just take advantage of the time, being Discovery Wrestling, being high on the momentum, and it just wanted it amped up. And he was, with the approval of the crowd, thanks to Joe Hendry, giving the crowd the opportunity to make their voice be heard. He was granted that title shot, and Leon Slater was added into the main event to make it a triple threat match. Gene Money now defending the Y Division Championship against Leon Slater and Ryan Richards for in the main event, which, you know what, I was buzzing. I was absolutely buzzing to see Leon Slater for the first time, and he really left a lasting impression on the Discovery Wrestling audience, and we were all in to see Leon Slater again. For I mean, two Leon Slater matches in one night for one charge, no brainer. We want to see that. So yeah, fantastic opening match for Discovery Wrestling. We moved on to a little bit of like the bad news, I suppose. Kings of the North, due to injury, had to vacate the Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Championships. So the next bout that was going to take place would be for the vacant Discovery Wrestling Y Division. I've done it again. I did it with the preview as well, but the Y Division title in my head. The Tag Team Championships were on the line and vacated. So the winners of a no disqualification match would become the new Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions. Out first was Skull Brawl, and we got Skull Brawl, who were the number one contenders that defeated the Good Times earlier in February. I think it was February, to get that title opportunity against Kings of the North. But they came up against the Good Times, Rob Stone, Monstrum, without Mr. Manaville, to have an absolute wild, chaotic brawl to determine the new Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions. And it was just that. It was absolutely chaotic. There was bodies everywhere. There was chairs brought in, a lot of chairs shots, rough chair shots as well. I think Rob Stowe was on the receiving end of quite a few on the back, thanks to the pleading of the crowd asking for one more time. And Lost by Aspen was quite happy to do that. I mean, Stowe did get his revenge with a power slam onto two sideways chairs, two set up sideways chairs. So there was a little bit of payback there. But eventually, we got to see Skull Brawl pick up the win and become the new Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions. A big win, a big fan favorite win in Discovery Wrestling. With the crowd at Discovery have really fallen in love with Skull Brawl, and they were rewarded handsomely when we got to see Skull Brawl become the new Discovery Wrestling Tag Team Champions. A phenomenal match. I really enjoyed it. Again, different. See the opening match, which was about athleticism and that kind of struggle. Got that struggle in this match, but it was more about the chaos in using the trying to gain numbers advantage, which the good times were very, very good at doing. But eventually it was Skull Brawl that would pick up the win. After that, we were welcomed by the Big Strong Man. The Big Strong Man appeared to make his Discovery Wrestling debut, and he challenged anyone on the Discovery Wrestling roster to face him. He left quite a lasting impression as well, much like Leon Slater earlier in the night. But he left a lasting impression, but was interrupted by Big Flex himself, Adam Maxted. And you know what? If you put this match on paper, I probably would have said, you know, it's going to be a bit of a mismatch, perhaps. But my goodness, the Big Strong Man, he put in a big strong shift against Adam Maxted, who may have underestimated his opponent somewhat. But Big Flex was able to power out of the Big Strong Man's maneuvers and power-based offense to eventually get the win. But that's not to be said about the Big Strong Man himself, who's an interesting character, an interesting sort, and we'll get to see if he'll appear more in Discovery Wrestling. But it was, again, a bit back and forth. Big Strong Man was able to flummox Adam Maxted for a little bit, Big Love Island's own Adam Maxted. And they say a little bit underestimated, perhaps, for Maxted over the Big Strong Man. But eventually, Maxted was able to pick up the win with a beautiful, I think it was a springboard dropkick, that eventually downed the Big Strong Man for 1-2-3. And an absolutely incredible contest. So really a surprise. A good surprising contest when you see, I guess, we see on paper, we see the matchup face-to-face. You think that it's going to be Big Flex that's going to just take over. But Big Strong Man, he had some big strong chops, but was unable to pick up the victory in the end. I'm just a really fun bout for Discovery. Up next, I think it was the main event of the first half, with the Discovery Wrestling Scottish Openweight Championship on the line, where Judas Grey took on Ravy Davey, which, again, going top to bottom on this, absolute back and forth contest where we got to see what Ravy Davey could offer. He got a little bit of his high flying maneuvers, his moonsaults and what have you. And we got Judas Grey showing a little bit more what he can do, again, with that high risk, high tempo style, just throwing his body into harm's way in order to gain an advantage or gain some victory. He wasn't really for gaining any fan favors, was Judas Grey. Unfortunately, he faked me out as he threatened to throw something at me, and he came out in a nice silky, light silky shirt number. I was very happy with that situation until he spotted me, went under the apron, and grabbed a big fleece and threw it at me. So he set the tone for his match there with that little fake out moment, and he was able to do that to Ravy Davey as well. Both then, like I say, put a little bit of high flying action in there. They were able to try and take the skies a little bit, use the ropes to their advantage for those springboard maneuvers. But eventually it was Judas Grey that would pick up the win and retain the Scottish Openweight Championship. But another phenomenal contest on this very stacked Discovery Wrestling show. So that was the first half. We still had more to go. So after you got to go get your photos with Joe Hendry and Adam Maxted in the ring, you're able to get a wee photo on there, but in the meantime you can go check the merch stand. There was a lot of wrestlers at ringside that you were able to discuss and be able to speak, get some photos with. So, including the tag team champions, the Discovery Wrestling tag team champions. So we got a little picture with Skull Brawl. Surprise, surprise! For anyone who knows me being a big Skull Brawl boy, it was great to see so many wrestlers. And good to see this camaraderie of the audience as well. But we returned for the second half with the Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship on the line, a triple threat when Emerson Jane took on Casey and the debuting Byla Grace in a triple threat, as I just said. This, again, I keep using the phrase back and forth because that's what it was. There was no clear-cut dominant in this triple threat match. There was always a moving part. There was always someone that was getting there and getting involved. Byla Grace maybe had a little bit of nerves in the early goings, but once she really got into the groove, she was a very dangerous competitor in the ring, and she was almost catching wins, catching falls here and there, if only it was to be interrupted by Emerson Jane and Casey, the more experienced opponents on there. Emerson threw out her offense. We got to see a double Shadowfax German suplex on the ropes onto Byla Grace and Casey. We got to see some just great moves. We've got to see some great action, and we've got to see a fantastic triple threat match. So as we were nearing the end of the evening, we were treated to a little bit of Ronan King coming out for a contest, an announced match on this show, only to be welcomed by the tune of The Gambler, which has been stuck in my head ever since. So you got to know when to hold them and you know when to show them. It was Dave Conrad making his return to Discovery Wrestling. It's been a long time since we've seen Dave Conrad in Discovery Wrestling. He's now got a new attitude, a new cowboy-like demeanor with the old cowboy hat and double denim going on. We're going to see Dave take on Ronan King, which, again, matchup I would have probably never expected to see or maybe not have concepted in my mind, because Dave Conrad has been away from wrestling for a number of years now. But he put on a fantastic performance, and Ronan King tried his best to try and pick up the pace, maybe get a little bit of speed going on there. But Dave Conrad was able to throw his weight around and able to get a big spinning burning hammer into the face of Ronan King en route to picking up victory. So a quick match at Ronan King, maybe unprepared for this new demeanor, this new character, this new persona of Dave Conrad. So before we got that, before we got to the main event, we had the raffle, which ended up with, now I am not aware of this kind of feud that's going on between Chip from the Disco Fry and James Erdos, but we were treated to a little bit of a, I don't know, comeuppance. James Erdos arrived with looking a bit shabby, a little bit disheveled, apparently lost his job after the antics of the previous Discovery Wrestling event when Chip attacked James Erdos. I think that's how it went down. I'll need that confirmed. But after a little bit of confrontation, Erdos ended up getting a rock bottom and a people's elbow. So it didn't really end up well for James Erdos once again, as Chip from the Disco Fry, who I think he has is a form open if you want to be employed in the Disco Fry. So go onto social media and you can find out more. I think I retweeted it possibly. Go check out Discovery Wrestling social media and you'll find out more. A very odd moment for someone who's just seeing Discovery Wrestling for the first time. But from what I'm aware of, what I've heard, this was a thing that happens quite often, or has happened in recent events in Discovery. But that all led to the main event. Triple threat match, Discovery Wrestling, Y Division Championship. Leon Slater was inserted at the last minute. Gene Money came out. Ryan Richards also challenging for the gold. And the opening match was absolutely incredible. It was bookended by another incredible contest. We got to see Gene Money defend for the last title. At this moment, he attempted to defend the Y Division Championship, but came up short when Leon Slater picked up the pinfall, used once again that Swanton 450 to pick up the win. I think I'd have to double check the footage, but I think he pinned Ryan Richards as well. So Gene Money has a little bit of an out there. He has a reason to be inserted back in to get again into the title picture when he has not been pinned. You know what? Let's go check the footage. I can check the footage because I still have the footage. We'll have a montage on the SWN podcast in the coming weeks. You'll get to see the old montage of Rooney. He pinned Ryan Richards. That is the way it happened, to become the new Y Division champion. So, an incredible moment. Gene Money showed his respect to the new champion, Leon Slater, despite Leon being added at the last minute. Maybe Gene Money wasn't prepared for someone of Leon Slater's high flying ability, because he was prepared for Ryan Richards, who's a bit more low to the ground, as far as in-ring maneuvers are, moveset are. But this was a very tight contest. Ryan Richards almost picked up the win using a low blow. There was some shenanigans aplenty during this match, and we got to see the absolutely phenomenal Leon Slater dive over the top turnbuckle to the outside onto his two opponents, where he landed on his feet. It was just insane. An absolutely fantastic match, an amazing contest, a match worthy of a main event, especially in this new era of Discovery Wrestling. So a fantastic match. Congratulations, Leon Slater, for becoming the new Discovery Wrestling Y Division champion. That wasn't all, though. The show wasn't over. We had Joe Henry come out to make his big announcement, and his big announcement that was promised. And before he could make that initial announcement, he was attacked by the Good Times, Monstrum, and Rob Stowe, and then was joined by Ryan Richards for good measure. And just as Adam Axton came back out to assist, Leon Slater tried to assist as well. And as the brawl was all happening, it looked like it was starting to settle down. Judas Gray appeared from the back and gave Joe Henry a low blow, to just add insult to injury. So it looks like we've now got a new faction of Joe Henry guys. Well, obviously bitter about their standing, I suppose, the respect that they're getting in Discovery Wrestling in Rob Stowe, Monstrum, Ryan Richards, and Judas Gray. But the announcement was made eventually, after all that attacks. Joe Henry was able to get back on the microphone, announced that Leon Slater would defend the Y Division Championship at the next show. Judas Gray Ryan Richards would get his comeuppance at the next show. But the big announcement would be that Discovery Wrestling is about to walk with Elijah. As the former Elias, or if you want to call him Ezekiel, in WWE, Elijah is coming to Discovery Wrestling in July, July 14th. Tickets are already available. If you want to go get a ticket, go get a ticket as soon as you possibly can, because Discovery Wrestling, Portobello Town Hall, will be walking with Elijah as they walk with Discovery Wrestling, as we're going to see Joe Henry, Adam Maxted, and Elijah take on the team of Rob Stowe, Monstrum, and Judas Gray. And what I would assume will be the main event, we're going to see the debut, Discovery Wrestling debut of Elijah. What a show! What a phenomenal contest! What a phenomenal match, show top to bottom. Every match, every championship match, every contest delivered and more. An absolute beautiful show. Thank you for Discovery Wrestling for allowing me into your spiritual home of the Portobello Town Hall, or via me buying a ticket via Discovery at DiscoWrestling.com. But I bought a ticket, I took the ride. It was an absolutely incredible night for Discovery. I will have more comments coming up in the SWN podcast, which should go out in next week, I think. I will also try and have a write-up on the SWN website, SWNScotland.com. But in the meantime, this has been all about the disco. I have been Billy. We'll see you in July for a preview as we go to Walk with Disco Wrestling. Wait, before I forget, sorry, extra bit here. Remember to go and buy Joe Henry's single, I Believe in Joe Henry. Now, go stream it on Spotify, go Apple Music, go iTunes, go whatever you need to do. Go check out I Believe in Joe Henry and get him up the charts. By this episode's going to go out today on the 1st of May. I've still got a couple of days to get that driven into the UK charts, US charts, any charts that you can think of. And we'll get to just confuse the world, as Joe Henry says. Go find out how confusing the world can be when we get I Believe in Joe Henry into the charts. Let's just do it. Let's go. I Believe in Joe Henry. Do you?
'Cause you love 'em in London and Paris and Tokyo, America, Scotland and Canada and Mexico. They say I believe in Joe Hendry. I believe in Joe Hendry.